3. Object mode. Clean. Press 3. Alright. So I made room, right? Press 1, press 1. Alt 5, wireframe unshaded. I'm gonna grab this wall. I'm gonna tuck it forward. So I got this line. It's gonna match up. Right? Again. Just all I did was push it forward. Next, this edge that I double clicked, right, versus this line, this edge loop, I'm gonna yank it up so it matches. Zoom in, boom, perfect alignment. I'm gonna stitch it. Click outside. Then, object mode, click outside. I'm gonna go and increment the save. This right. Next, I'm going to double click, select this. Well, first of all, this needs to be fixed up a bit. But before I do that, I'm going to add an edge loop here so I can connect it. So, shift right click, insert edge loop. Click on this vertical line, drag, click and drag it up to here. And I let go. Press W. Did not like that. Alright, so I'm gonna, well, first of all, I undid it. Something's goofy. Insert edge loop. Zoom in. Click, and I'm gonna stop it right there. Press W. Actually, okay, I need to pull this down. I need about this much clearance. Maybe around here? Because if I make a supporting edge running around. Right. So I'm going to give about this much clearance. Yeah. Here, click. Right. Then I'm gonna grab this, and we'll push this back like this much. This one right here. Right. Before. After. Mode. So I gave this much clearance. Right now, this part is getting kind of haywire, right? Getting super flat. So again, I'm gonna touch it up, vertex mode, and I'm gonna just grab, edge mode. I'm gonna grab this edge, right? The back wall. I'm gonna pull it out of it. Basically, I need more clearance for my back. So it kind of curves out as a nice curve. So I'm just fluffing it up a little bit more because I have to compensate because of this. I'm making this extra space to slot in the arm. Grab this, I'm gonna push this out a bit, like around this much. Maybe a little bit more. I'm gonna grab this, push it out, right? Before, after, before, after. Press 3, press 1. Next. Alright, from here, right, I need to add another edge loop up here running. Shift right click. Alright, object mode. Shift right click, insert edge loop. I'm gonna click on one of these vertical lines. I'm gonna dump it right around here. Before, after. Right. I'm gonna explain everything that's happening. Since I did that just now, I'm gonna follow my rule again. I'm gonna grab these, right, the upper. I'm gonna just push them in. Before, after. I do not have edge slide on. I just manually push it in. Then, I'm looking around. This part is skewing out like this. Same rule applies. I'm gonna turn on edge slide this time. I'm gonna slide this back in so it evens out nicely. This is skewing out like this, so I don't want that. I'm gonna pull this in like that. Maybe I'll pull up like that. Again, push it this way, and then pull up this way. So it has nice spacing. Same thing. This time I'm gonna grab this entire edge. I'm gonna slide it up. Right, see? Nice proportional spacing. This right here, maybe I can pull it down a bit. Right, meaning pull it like this. Alright. Good. This right here needs to align. I'm gonna grab this edge, right, and I'm gonna slide it like that. So it lines up. And that's it. Click outside. Next. Incremental save. This right here I don't like. Turn it off. Edge slide, turn off the edge slide. This right here is doing this weird angle, so I'm gonna pull forward, right? Then I'm gonna pull out. So I have a nice running train tracks and my angles are more or less reasonable. Yeah. This right here, maybe I'll push it back a bit. Again, before, after. So all that prep. So what I'm gonna do from here is select it. Right, level 1. Shift right click, or not incremental save. Shift right click, multi-cut tool. I'm gonna use this right here, right? here, snap it to here. I'm gonna click outside right around here. Turn a bit, I'm gonna click and drag and dump it here. Now I'm gonna turn my camera a bit right around here. I'm gonna just click and I'm dragging and letting go right around here. Then I'm going to just terminate it or end it, clicking here, drag it and snap. Bop, 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 press W. One section at a time. Press shift right click, multi cut. I'm gonna click and snap. Turn the camera. I'm gonna click onto this edge. Stop it right around there. Turn the camera. I'm gonna zoom in. I'm gonna click right around here. And up to here. Then I'm gonna click here and snap it like that. Press W. Shift right click, multi cut, click and snap, click in around here, click around here. Then I'm gonna click on this edge and snap it. Shift right click, multi cut again, click and snap, click right around here. Click on this edge, snap it, press W. There you go. Right click, face. Select that, delete. Select that, delete. Select that, delete. Select that, delete. Right. So this sets up the, more or less the socket. This and this. Incremental save. What I want to do from here is let me look at my original mesh. I don't like this. Went out and in. So maybe I'm gonna push this in. Right? This part right here. I'm gonna push this out a bit. This part right here, this edge loop, right, I'm gonna grab these, this three, tuck it out a bit, before, after. Basically, I'm following my rules that I stated, that whenever I add additional geometry, I'm gonna put them to use, so it rounds out, and not just become a flat, rigid surface. Part right here. Right. Pull out of it. So it's kind of getting a little bit more bulky. Right. You know, tuck it back a little bit. This half is getting not working anymore. So, face mode. Select all these faces. Turn that off. Select all these faces. Backspace. Press 5. This face, I do not have edge slide on. I'm gonna pull this out. This is this face right here, this edge, vertex. I kinda don't like it as pinching in, so I'm gonna pull it, chuck it back out a bit. give it some width right there. See this wall, this right here, this is looking from the back. Check it out a bit so I get my wall back out. See, that's why I'm doing that. This wall, right, maybe I'll pull it out a bit. Level 3, level 1. Press this level 1 so you can see it better. Low poly. Grab this vertex right here. It pinches inward. Maybe I'll tuck it out. Grab this. Maybe I'll also tuck that out. So it flares out. Grab this. I'll tuck this out. So I have a nice shoulder slot. Grab this. Pull this out. So I have a nice big chunky planes. And if they all breathe well. Ooh, this part, what's going on here? See, I don't like this. I'm gonna push this out a bit. Anytime I say anything kinda off, grab this, maybe I'll cut this out a bit. Yeah, see? Grab vertices. The inside of my arm, I'm gonna pull it out. Then I'm gonna pull it back in so it's right around here, right? I'm in a level 3 mode. I'm gonna grab that. I'm gonna pull this in a bit so it touches up to here, right? Ish. Press 1, 1 and 1, grab this, and we'll push this in up to here. I'll grab this, push this in up to here, turn the camera underneath the armpit. I'm gonna push this in. I'm not gonna move it this way, right, because I wanna keep my line clean. I'm gonna move this probably. Pull this in up to here. Grab this, pull this in up to here. Grab this, pull this in up to here. This right here, I'm gonna pull this out up to here. Grab this one. I'm gonna pull this out up to here. I only moved in this arrow axis. Click outside. Incremental save. Very clean. Select this, select that. Shift right click, hold it, go to combine. Combined. Select it. I don't like the history. Delete history. Zoom in. Press 3. Nearly one mesh. Now all I'm going to do is shift right click. And you know what? No, hold on the right mouse button. Choose vertex mode. Press 1. I'm going to combine these. Shift right click. Merge vertices. Target well. I'm going to combine the body's vertex to the vertex of the limb. So the body's vertex here, it's gonna connect to the vertex of the limb or the cylinder. Again, zoom in, right? Body's vertex, left click, drag and snap it. Zoom in. Right, turn the camera. Again, the body's vertex is here. I'm going to move it and snap it to the cylinder arm vertex. Body's vertex, move and snap it. Turn the camera, body's vertex, move and snap it. Pan up, body's vertex, snap it. Finally, body vertex, snap it. Press W, press 3, boom. And that's how you connect it. Alt 5. I'm thinking this limb is massive, so what I'm gonna do, right, is I'm gonna be in W, move tool, and hold control, right, hold the middle mouse and pull so it scales in, right, pull. Maybe it's too thin. Maybe I'll hold control, middle mouse and drag left or right, so it partially scales in, like that, something like that. Alright, maybe a little bit more, something like that. Okay, that's delete history. Select my mesh. I want it to look faceted. So I'm going to mesh display, harden edge. Alt 5. Grab that. Maybe I'll push that in a bit. Grab these. Maybe I'll push that out a bit so my lines flow. Grab that, push this out. Grab this, because this line is going like this. So I'm going to push this out. This back here. Face mode. Grab that face. Right click face mode. Maybe I'll give it some more width for this face. Click outside. Alt 5. Yeah. Select this. Edit. Duplicate special option box. Instance negative one. Apply. Shit. Didn't work because my pivot point is at the. Ooh. Is over here. Press D as in David. Turn on my grid snapping icon. I have D as in David activated for move pivot. Snap it here. Right down the middle of my grid because my grid snapping is turned on. Press W to get out of the live pivot. Uncheck this. Alright, so it's right down the middle. Negative 1 instance. Apply. Close. Press 3. Boom. There you go. I need an edge loop over here. Insert edge loop, click, drag, right around here, ish. This has to do with later on, if this character is gonna be animated with the skeleton bones, right? Here's my train tracks that I constantly talk about, right? See how nicely looping around each other? This tells me that more or less it will nicely bend and deform. I have at least two rolls You need minimum two, probably three. But could work with what we have right now. And it transitions into the sidewall with nice spacing, which is exactly what I've been talking about the past several weeks. There. And I can go back into modeling the other stuff. This looks pretty cute. Pretty cute. Yeah. Incremental save. Turn off the X-ray. The head is a totally different story. Yeah. It's another beast to deal with. But we have this set up. Alright, so that's the end of that. I'm gonna chop up this video into different parts. Maybe 20 minutes a pop. And I'll go from there. Alright, good luck, bye.